Hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Yesterday we answered this Ustad Abdul Abdul Samad, who have no idea what Islam is about, and he was speaking about the Christian's cross have a genie, and that is because Muslims, they are really they're brainwashed and their mind controlled by superstition things. However, our topic today is not about that. Our topic today is about different Abdul. This Abdul, his name is Shahib, Ustad Shahib or Shahib. I think they don't know how to say the word correctly in Arabic, so they give themselves Arabic names and they look funny after that with it. I will let you hear what he said. I don't know really what he's saying in the language, but somebody sent me a translation.
Sewaktu rombongan ini pulang, diskusi menyangkut akidah tidak ketemu. Ya kan? Kepercayaan umat Kristiani menyangkut Tuhan beda dalam sifat-sifatnya menyangkut ini. Tapi itu tidak menghalangi Nabi menulis perjanjian. Menjanjikan.
All right, enough stupidity. First of all, there's nothing is called the covenant of the Nasara of Najran. It's a big fat fabrication. The only covenant Muhammad he have with those who call Nasara, which means the Christians supposedly, is to strip them from their money and to force them to pay Muhammad. I will go to a Muslim website and I did not find something in English, so I found in Arabic, but I did a translate using Google Translation. And you will see even the Muslim scholar, they say that this is fabrication. All what those people, they say, it's a lie, it's not exist, and there is no even source for it, which means the story cannot be found anywhere. So those idiots who kept copy-paste the same as many copy-paste, as an example, the story of Muhammad, a neighbor who was a Jew, and he threw garbage at his door. But we cannot find the story anywhere. The same as the story of Muhammad, he went in a cave and a spider, he made a web, spider web, and he protected him from the infidels. But we cannot find the story. Those are stories, nobody knows where they are coming from. It's stupid, it's false. Let us go to Islamic official website and see what they say about this false story. This is IslamWeb.net, very well known. And this is a translation from the Arabic fatwa, fatwa number 308620, as you see in the front of you in the screen. All right, I'm highlighting that for you. So this is the fatwa number, you can check it out. A person, he quote exactly what that idiot in the video was saying, that the Prophet, he did this with the Christians, he treat them nice, blah, 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 blah. This is not true, absolutely false. And this is even against the Quran. So you will see here this guy is asking, did the Messenger of Allah, peace upon him, wrote this document to the Christians of Najran, etc. And I'm going to leave a link down so you can read it yourself. And, you know, he told them, etc., etc., you are protected, blah, 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 your churches, blah, 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 blah. And then the answer comes down and says, this is not true. We did not find the treaty in this world in some book of the Hadith, biography, but we found some else. And what he found, that the Christians have to pay jizya, which means pay or die. And here the thing is highlighted in English, in Ibn Ishaq. And funny, if you say to Muslims Ibn Ishaq, they say, oh, we don't accept Ibn Ishaq. But suddenly they take stories. It exists nowhere. Even what you see from those videos is this story in the top. But we cannot find this story. The story is that the Christians of Najran, they paid jizya. And what is jizya? Jizya is a penalty. And we'll explain it to you from the Quran. So this is, they have to pay Muhammad money in order for return of peace. This is jizya, which means they have to pay him to live. Muhammad is a mafia guy, he's a gang man, he is an ugly criminal. You pay, you live. You don't pay, I will kill you. And here, this is what is in Ibn Ishaq. But still, by the way, we cannot find this like in Sahih al-Bukhari, etc. But even here, the truth is that they have to pay in order to live. And here you will see another quotation from that Ibn Sa'd, from the book of At-Tabaqat al-Kubra. Same is saying the same, that you have to pay me, etc., from your fruit, from your money, from etc., from your horses, from animals. And if you, I send you my messengers, you have to feed them, you have to arm them, you have to give them rest, you have to give them accommodation, as you see in front of you. So what they say is absolutely false. So look at this. And they have to give Muhammad, when he sent, each time he sent his messengers to Muhammad, to them, they have to give them, etc. They have to host them for etc. days, all for free. They have to give them armors and horses. They have to give them all those things. And this is just by enforcement. This is not a covenant. You see, when you say covenant, it says, okay, we have peace between us. This is not what they are saying. Muhammad, he force rules, pay or die. Let us go to the Quran and get them busted. So first of all, this is Treaty of Najran is a fabrication. Let us go to the Quran. This is Muhammad's book saying that anyone is not Muslim is filthy, dirty. So how they say to us he treat them nice and he was nice to them when he is teaching his followers that we are najis. Najis is not, it's mean you are not just dirty, which means no shower can clean you. You are filthy. You are filthy inside out. So we are forbidden. There is no gozoon, which means Muhammad and Islam believe in the same as when the white people treat the black people, no gozoon. If you are a black person, you cannot take this bus because this bus is only for the white. This is the filthy teaching of Muhammad. The truth is in front of you. So if you are a non-Muslim, you are filthy. You cannot take our bus. And until now, there is signs in the highway in Saudi Arabia says Muslims only. Why? Because non-Muslims are filthy, dirty. As you see in front of you in the screen, non-Muslim goes from here, Muslims, they go from here. And actually, if you are a person who live in Saudi Arabia, they will give you a color of a brown for your residency. If you are a Muslim, they will give you, if you are not a Muslim, they will give you brown. If you are a Muslim, they will give you white because you are the clean one and non-Muslims are the dirty one. So what they are talking about? Let us see what the Quran and how Islam understand treating the Christians. First, we go actually from Muhammad. Muhammad, he said, because he's a very nice man, he was very good to the Christian of Najran. If you see a Christian in the street, you have to spit in his face and you have to force him to walk in the sewage. And not only that, you have to harass him, humiliate him. Let us read together. After Muhammad, he made an order that no non-Muslims can go to Mecca. Muslim, they say, okay, we will get poor now because nobody will do business with us. We became like a bunch of crazy people who they are fighting everybody, hating everybody, and nobody will come to Mecca. You just forbid everyone from coming to Mecca. So how we will do now? He says, oh, hold on. Allah told me this. If you fear that you are going to be in a poverty. So if you fear you are going to be in poverty. Okay, they fear it already. So what the solution? Go and attack and kill the Christians and take their money. وَإِنْ خُفْتُمَ غِيْرَةً فَسَوْفَ يُغْنِيكُمُ اللَّهِ If you are afraid of poverty, Allah will make you rich. But how Allah will make them rich? Read carefully. Right away he says, go and force them to pay you the money and feel themselves subdued. Who? The Christians, jizya as you see. So, and feel themselves subdued. Ayah means that this is will be a compensation for the closed market that you forced would result. Therefore, Allah compensate them, who the Muslims, for the lose of their business because they served ties with adulterers by the jizya. They earned from the people of the book. You see how he treated us nice? So the Muslim now, their life depend on us. They do have no job. They have no work. They just fight. They are warrior. They are thieves. And now, if we could not find money? No worry. We will attack the Christians. We will force them to pay jizya. And those money from the people of the book, you will live from it. So they became officially a bunch of thieves. And here you will see Muhammad saying the following. And I'm just reading, as you see, what it says here. This is not my own fiction or creation. They say to us the covenant of Najran, but Muhammad, he said, as you see, which is false there, doesn't exist, that Muhammad says, go and kill, fight against those who believe not in Allah. From who? From the Christians. Which means those who don't believe in Muhammad, they have to be either killed or they have to pay money. From among the people of the scriptures, because why? They did not acknowledge Muhammad as a prophet. Until they pay jizya with willing submission, as you see. So Muhammad, he came with this excuse. It was not really his target to fight the Christian in the beginning, but because, as you see, the Muslim now, they fear poverty. So he wanted to, okay, we want to cover the poverty which is happening now because we forbid people from coming to Mecca. So he made an order to attack and kill the Christian to steal their money. And if you are a Christian and you want to live, well, you have to pay us. And not only you have to pay us, because some Muslim, they will say to you, oh, this is just a tax. Don't you pay tax? Read carefully. This tax is not a tax. It is a jizya, which means die or pay. And not only die on pay, you have to pay it and you have to be subdued. You have to be humiliated because you refuse Islam. Read carefully here. I'm going to post the link for this too, so you can read and laugh at those who lie to you. Say the prophet, he made a covenant with the Christian. Well, here we will see the real covenant with the Christians. Here we go. Let us see here. I will go down a little bit. Until they pay the jizya, if they do not choose to embrace Islam, because Muhammad, it says, fight them, okay, fight them, we conquer them, then we offer them one of two. Either you embrace Islam or you pay a jizya and you live like a dog. Am I saying that from my own? No, read carefully. With willing submission and defeat, here it says, and feel themselves subdued, disgraced, humiliated. Do you see it, my friend? Are you blind? What covenant? What covenant this person is talking about? This is the covenant of Muhammad. This is the only covenant. Die if you don't pay, or live like a dog and you still have to pay me money. And here, not only that, Muhammad, he says, therefore, the Muslims are not allowed to honor the people of the Dhimma. Who is the people of the Dhimma? The Christian. This is the covenant, people of the covenant. So we have a covenant. If we pay them, we live. But we live like dogs. We don't live like a human, first-class citizen. No, you are no one. And you have to be humiliated. And this is why people of the Dhimma are not allowed to be elevated. Muslims cannot elevate us, to treat us the same equal to Muslim, for we are miserable, disgraced, humiliated, as you see. And not only that, the Prophet said, read carefully, the Prophet said, this is not Ustad's stupid idiot potato tomato. This is the Prophet, you see. Don't take those donkeys and they put in the front of their names Ustad to make themselves like they are like a master of knowledge. But the fact they are a bunch of donkeys and they try to deceive you. The Prophet said, okay, what the Prophet said? Don't initiate salam to the Jews and the Christians. And if you meet any of them on the road, force them to the most narrow alley. Which means you have to be harmful for them. You have to be disgusting to them. You have to spit in their face. And the narrow alley here, translation, is for the sewage. In the old day, the sewage was open in the side of the road. So if you walk in the road and then there is a sewage, you know, in the side, and you are a Christian, he is a Muslim, the Muslim have a duty. It's not only it's an option, he have to do. He have to humiliate the Christians and force him to walk in the sewage. And then if you want to see the real covenant, here we go. Read the covenant of Umar ibn al-Khattab with the Christians of Jerusalem. When he attacked Syria and Jerusalem and etc., he made a covenant. And this covenant says, we will humiliate you. We will treat you like dogs. We will read it. It's in the front of you. Actually, I will post the link for you. And this is the real, this is the translation of Muslim, by the way. When Muslim, they give you a translation like this, it means it's more horrible in Arabic. So you will see here, Umar ibn al-Khattab, the leader of the faithful, he says, like, this is why Umar ibn al-Khattab, he put conditions on the people of the Sham, which means Syria, Lebanon, Jerusalem, etc. And the condition is to live like a dog. And you can read the treaty here. You will see that they have to pay money. They have to host them. A Muslim can sleep in your house for 3 days for free anytime he wants. So my friend, don't listen to those idiots giving you false fiction. Thank you for watching. Share the video, translate and add subtitle. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And by the way, I have a gift for the Indonesian. I will mention it in soon video. As a response for those who call themselves Ustad, will be very good gift for all Indonesian Christians and Muslims. Thank you. Christ is Lord. Thank you to that.